with Dr. Kim Hammond from Falls Road Animal Hospital. How are you?
I'm great. And this is Gwen.
Hi, Gwen.
And Gwen is a Chihuahua.
She's got her O's jersey on.
It's got her O's jersey on.
She's number one.
She's an O's fan. She's got her O's accessories.
Oh, she is too sweet. A Chihuahua. That's
she's
a new
half,
one to me.
Yeah, she's half weenie and half chihuahua.
She's cute.
She's a tweenie.
All right, we've got several questions as we admire her. Samia says, one of our cats recently passed away. Our remaining cat seems depressed and is losing his fur. We're giving him as much attention as he will allow us to give. Is there anything else we can be doing?
You know, the losing fur may not be related to depression, but I have to tell you something. There is now a master cat groomer in Baltimore. And if you call me at the Falls Road Animal Hospital, I'll put you in touch with her. But I would say if your cat's losing its fur, maybe go to a cat groomer, let them brush the cat out. It could be blowing its winter coat, might be perfectly normal, not related to the depression. And as far as the depression's concerned, there are a plethora of little toys and devices and things like that we can use, including a new kitty cat.
Okay. Next one, our German Shepherd puppy has been having digestive issues for a couple weeks. We've taken her to the vet, and all of her tests have come back normal. We think she may have a food allergy. What's the best way to figure out if she's allergic?
Okay, so let me answer that two ways. First of all, an elimination diet. You take everything away, and you start bringing things back. And you have to talk to your veterinarian about that, and actually a dermatologist about it. Because a veterinary dermatologist, even though it may be a GI problem, because if it's a food allergy, those guys, the veterinary dermatologists, are the smartest in terms of elimination diets and bringing things back one at a time.
Okay.
But there's a report in the Journal of Veterinary Medicine this month, actually this week, that talks about the truth in labeling in over-the-counter dog foods. Many of the over-the-counter dog foods, in fact, they said all of them, are misrepresenting their fiber content. So you don't really understand what you're feeding. That's fascinating. So you may be thinking you're giving a particular diet and it's consistent, and bag to bag it's not.
Right.
Again, I would talk to an expert and get some help.
Okay, good advice. Yeah. And Carol writes, what would be a safe and healthy way to put an overweight 4-year-old Chihuahua-rat terrier mix on a diet? She's very active, but I'm afraid her weight will cause future problems for her tiny legs.
First of all, let's make sure metabolically she's healthy. She doesn't have diabetes or Addison's. A lot of these little dogs that get pot bellies and maybe they have thin hair actually have endocrine disease. They actually have something wrong with their glands. Okay. So you want to check that out.
Could be something else.
Yeah, it could be something else. Check that out.
All right, thanks, Gwen.
All right, see you.
Bye, sweetie.
Go O's!
Thanks, Dr. Kim.
Go O's! Oh.